Welcome back to Proactive. Today, I'm joined by Flynn Gold CEO, Neil Marston. Neil, lovely to have you back in our studio today. Have you been keeping well?
Yes, great to be with you, Alicia. And yeah, looking forward to a few days off over Christmas. Thank you.
Yes, that time of year is certainly rolling around, but it has been a very busy period for Flynn Gold in recent months. First off, let's talk about your recent RC drilling. You announced some results from this program this week. Can you explain the significance?
Yes, Alicia, the program saw us drill 12 RC holes across three locations at a project called Golden Ridge. And the three prospects we drilled at were Kensington, Blinding, and the Link Zone. These prospects are about 6 kilometres apart along a prospective contact of granodiorite and methena sediments. And we drilled 2 to 5 holes at each of those target areas, which we'd identified through surface sampling. And the good thing was we hit gold mineralisation at each location, which is a pretty impressive result. Certainly the result at Link Zone was very exciting. We hit a 33 meter wide zone averaging about 0.5 gram gold from 40 meters depth, with multiple zones grading about 2 grams per ton gold. And the Link Zone lies between the Briant and Trafalgar prospects, which are the only two areas we've drilled previously. They're about 2.5 kilometers apart. So the fact we've been able to find mineralization at the Link Zone between these two prospects is very significant, because it really indicates the potential to find a lot more gold in that corridor. And then over at Kensington, which is 4 kilometres to the west of the Briant prospect, we also intersected shallow gold in some of the drilling there. And that result really opens up the western half of a 8 kilometre contact zone that we've got at Golden Ridge. So we're looking forward to doing more exploration across the whole of the contact, including drilling going forward.
Neil, you mentioned the Trafalgar prospect just then. I understand you've got the diamond drill rig on site there and it's working away at a program. In the past at Trafalgar, you've incorporated results like 12.3 metres at 16.8 grams per tonne gold. So some pretty high grade hits here. Can you give some colour as to the current program?
Right. Well, on Monday, we updated the market generally, and we stated that we'd completed drilling hole 6, which we drilled down to a depth of 295 metres. So this hole was drilled between two holes, holes number 2 and number 5, and was really designed to test 2 gold-bearing veins, which we'd intersected in those two holes, including that high intersection, which you just mentioned. So visuals on hole 6 indicate that we've intersected those two veins, the first one at about 83 to 91 metres depth and the latter at around 225 to 229 metres. So we're waiting on those samples being put through for assays, and they'll be announced in due course, probably in the new year. And now what we've done is we've turned the rig around and commenced hole number 7, and that hole is testing the same vein zones but further to the east and closer to that really good hit in hole number 5. So the program will keep going into 2023, and we're well underway with planning and permitting so that we'll be able to continue drilling a whole bunch of new holes, testing Trafalgar early into the new year. Including in that, we expect we'll be bringing another drill rig onto site to speed up the work rate and to allow us to report and confirm additional intersections as quickly as possible in the new year.
All right, lots happening on the ground at your exploration camps then. I understand, Neil, that the recent capital raise you announced will also help with those activities. How is that tracking?
Yes, Alicia, we've announced a capital raising which consists of a $1.3 million placement of new shares at 10 cents per share, and that will settle tomorrow. And in addition, we've announced a partly underwritten $4.8 million entitlement offer to existing shareholders on a 1-for-2 shares basis, also at 10 cents. So the offer booklet will be mailed out to shareholders later in the month and will close on the 17th of January 2023. So those funds will be used primarily to fund a number of activities. Obviously, we've got a major program planned at Golden Ridge, with a focus on drilling out the Trafalgar area where we've hit those earlier results we mentioned. And also we've got a large holding of tenements in Western Australia, which are very prospective for lithium, which we want to start some exploration on the ground in 2023. So a lot happening next year, and certainly with those funds we've raised through the capital raising, we look forward to being very active.
Neil, we're looking forward to your next update in the new year. Thanks so much for providing your insights and your time today.
Thanks, Alicia. Have a good Christmas.